The Application Builder allows you to develop both internal and public web-based applications on top of your Baserow database or other data sources. This video focuses on data sources. A data source acts as a bridge between your application and an external data source, such as a Baserow table. You can add multiple data sources to your application, even within the same page. In this chapter, you will learn how to create a new data source, use existing views, show the data source in a table element, and add additional filters and sorting. There is a database that schedules recurring events on a certain date and location. Each event requires an amount of staffing. The application must show all the events scheduled for this month and all the upcoming events that are yet understaffed. This information can be found in the database as a grid view of the schedules table. The application is already created and contains a single page with an image element as the header and the title elements. Let's create a new data source that shows all the upcoming events for this month. Click the data button located on the top of the page to add a new data source. Give the data source a descriptive name, like this month. Indicate if the data source should fetch a single record based on an ID or a collection of records. In this case, it will be a collection of scheduled events. Now, it is time to specify where the data must come from. This will be a local Baserow database from the same workspace. After that, select a specific database and table that holds the data you want to show. You have the option to select a specific view. This is particularly useful when there is already a filtered and sorted view, like in our case. Records that are not part of this view can never be part of the data source. With the data source established, it is time to visualize the data on the page. Select the title element and click the plus button at the bottom to add an element beneath the title. Select the table element from the panel. A table is a collection element and therefore it requires a data source. Select the data source named this month. Notice that the table already displays the appropriate number of rows, but they are still empty. So let's define the columns. Each column has a name or title on top and a designated type, which can be text or link. The value must be selected from the fields of the data source. It is possible to combine multiple fields into a single column. For example, the deficit symbol and the name of the event. Since the event is a linked field, which is always a list of items, you cannot directly select the name, but need to choose to select the first element or all elements and display the respective value. Additional fields can be added with the plus button. Let's link the other fields, like the date and required staffing, from the data source. It is worth noting that the data source doesn't completely align with the requirements. It fetches all scheduled events for the current month, including those that have already passed. This can be solved by adding an additional filter to ensure that only future events are included. To implement this filter, reopen the data source and click on the Add Additional Filter button to set up an extra condition. Here, select the relevant field, in this case, the date and time field, and specify the condition that it must be after today. Notice the immediate update of the items in the table. The events in the database are sorted in ascending order based on their date and time. For our application purpose, we aim to sort them based on the shortfall in staff members for each event. To achieve this, click on the Source button and sort the data source in descending order by deficit. Once again, observe the immediate update of the data in the table element. The same techniques can be applied to create a second data source on the page. This data source includes all scheduled events with understaffing. The data is also displayed in the table element. Linking a data source to your Baserow application is crucial if you aim for more than just a basic website with static content. It empowers you to fetch data in real time, creating dynamic and engaging user experiences. You have the flexibility to reuse the views from your database while it is still possible to add additional filters and sorting. A data source collection can be displayed in a collection element, like a table.